SpaceX comments, take one.
And then,
first of all, everybody from my right to left can introduce themselves to speaking straight to the camera.
And what we do. Hello, I'm Martin Johnson. I'm specialist in propulsion here at Rolls-Royce, and I do all future program work.
Hello, I'm Dickon Skinner. I'm the program executive for the Rolls-Royce lift system.
Hello, I'm Alexa Clayton. I'm a manufacturing engineer working on TP400 assembly at Rolls-Royce.
Hi, I'm Matthew Wills. I'm currently a graduate engineer here working in future programs.
Today we're going to go through some of the questions that you guys wrote for the Tesla SpaceX launch, and you're going to get our version of the answers. Why was SpaceX allowed to launch a car into orbit? Yeah, why not, I think.
Well, you want to make sure you can launch something. So you're not going to put something really, really expensive and like a brand new satellite on a rocket. Well,
to me, his car is really, really expensive.
Yeah. It's pretty expensive. Yeah, I can't afford it.
What would you launch into space, man?
I have no idea. A giant laser.
Excellent. Lexi? Yeah.
What would I launch into space? I don't know.
I don't know, like lots of donuts or something. This is a great one. Why aren't stars visible? So that's from Hedy Lamarr and Eddie Byrne. Now, I thought stars were visible last time I checked.
Pretty sure during the video.
Okay.
Is this?
Yeah, so when they weren't visible when they were showing it.
What? Well,
going
into
because
space,
it was so dark.
Plus,
if you're
see stars
shining
daylight.
Something up bright, you're not going to see the
you're not going to see
the contrast
on
difference.
Yeah. Great answer. Why aren't parts of the car melting? And that's from Alex Jones.
Melting.
It's quite cold in space, isn't it?
Well, it is, and it's not like it's not going to be boiling hot at the tip of it. Well, it'd be hot, but not hot enough to melt metal.
Yeah, it'd be a poor designed rocket if it vaporized the cargo on the way up.
Yeah.
And actually, as the rocket goes up, the tip of it going up, it doesn't actually get that hot.
Next question. How long should it take for the sun to bleach white the leather, since there is nothing protecting it from the sun's bright rays and radiation? Hmm. Well, Lexi, you've got a leather jacket today.
I think it would have gone quite a long way away from the sun before that. Maybe when it kind of starts to come back.
Yeah.
So maybe you can send out another one to have a look at the car and replace the seats when carries on.
Yes, so you need a resupplying mission.
Yeah.
Could a leak or exploding tires set off the car off its trajectory?
Well,
absolutely, yes.
Yeah.
Technically, it's going to be outgassing the whole time it's up there, so there's going to be little pockets of air all over the place, and they're going to have to escape. So the trajectory is going to have minor alterations as it goes, and that's one of the reasons they find it hard to track.
So I was thinking about this earlier. What pressure would you put in the tyres so that they don't explode, though, when it goes into space? Could you get away with normal pressures, or would you have to let some air out?
Depends on the rubber in the tyres.
Yeah, you'd probably get away with normal pressures.
From Michael saying, why isn't he melting? I don't know if that's Elon or the mannequin.
I imagine the mannequin.
Okay. Why is he not melting, Lexi?
He's nowhere near the flame, is he? The same purpose as the rocket's not going to... Or the car's not going to melt. He's hopefully not going to melt until he comes back to re-entry.
Oh, a wild card.
Well,
what about people who believe the Earth is flat?
What you talking about?
That's stupid.
I just like their idea that there's giant ice walls at one side of the planet. Oh, sorry, can you call it a planet if it's just a flat thing?
Okay.
There was a great quote, I think Alex might need to correct me on this, but it was, people all around the world believe it's flat.
All around.
So thanks for watching. It's been great to have billions and billions of you checking into our channel to see what's going on Project Starship. If you've got any comments, comment below, and we'll engage with you through that. If you haven't got any comments, we'll make some up, because it's probably all fake anyway.